Get your attention! I'm just kidding. This is Dragon Ball Z instead of Bleach. I wouldn't mind LPing a don't make LPs or called walkthroughs because I gotta be anal about that. So this pretty much is an LP. But yeah, in the last part we did some stuff and we got a new move for Piccolo and a new move for Gohan. And we're about to go fight some androids. But before we do that, we gotta get a match to Roshi and get something from him. There's no capsules here, so you're not missing anything. And don't expect there to be a whole lot of action. There's gonna be a shit ton of talking, dialogue, and whatnot. So we talk to him, and we get the spin punch, which every character has a different technique, but it's all performed the same way. I think Piccolo's is by far the worst, because you hold A, and you do a spin move, and you do some damage. The thing is, I've been recording for a minute, I hope. But, watch, we'll get Gohan's. Switch the Kai Blast. And come on, go get the stop ringing every goddamn thing. And, we get the super kick technique, which, super kick, huh? Yeah. You perform the same way, but it launches you. Everyone's little hold A move has that, like, can do that. Alright, it launches them. So, now after we got that out of the way, let's go ahead and go to, whatever fucking island that Star's on. Let's speed that up. And now we're here, and we're gonna talk to Gohan. If you don't think that, I'm nuts for asking this, but what's the deal with the baby, Bulma? And we find out that, that Bulma and Vegeta did the nasty. And they had a baby. Named Trunks. Which totally isn't the guy from the future. He's a completely different Trunks. Ha ha ha. Gohan still looks evil. Not Gohan, Goku. Damn. What am I? Idiot? Yes. Vegeta's off trying to become a Super Saiyan, and we're probably gonna get Vegeta in this part. It's basically just a bunch of dialogue, and then Vegeta. If you just got Yajirobe. Damn, man. What am I, a fucking idiot? Yes, I am. But now he gives us a sensu bean, that nice guy. Thank you for that sensu bean. We need it. Still looking to make up. Like I said, there's gonna be a way where we can be able to get as many sensu beams as we want. Just not now. Yamcha's being useless as shit. Yamcha, no one likes you! I see them. Don't see shit. Piccolo, because you're a. Nah, I was reading out a pop up. That should have been at the bottom of my screen. Piccolo, because you're a Saiyan. I'm just kidding, he's not a Saiyan. But speaking of more stupid 4Kids stupid shit, and one of the advertisements for, I think it was the second episode of Dragon Ball Z, where it's like, Raditz kidnapped Goku's son, and Piccolo, who's a Saiyan just like Raditz. And I'm like, what the fuck? Are these people that fucking stupid? And the funny part is, it's the voice for, is it still Jason Griffith? I don't fucking know. It's like the guy who voices Sonic the Hedgehog. He's the one doing the announcement, which made it funny, because I remember seeing a comment that said, Sonic the Hedgehog obviously lacks knowledge in terms of Dragon Ball Z. I found them! In all caps. Yep, they killed Yamcha. I got two androids. So these are the androids. Kind of funny looking, if you ask me. Of course, I find it even more surprising that you have kept your arrival on the island. Goku has the right idea, but nope. Android 17, aka, I'm not 17, 20. Go ahead and be the douche. Oh wait, his name is Dr. Gero. He's the real Dr. Gero. He made himself into an android. Why the fuck would he do that? This clown bitch right there, and I actually, on my practice save file, I've already gotten all the way to the part where I've had to fight that android. And I almost lost. So, imagine how I'm doing that when I am doing commentary. Yeah, not too well. Not as much dialogue as I remembered. Ooh, damn, we've already spent 5 minutes just non-stop dialogue. And we see a Caps Corp ship, and I wonder who's in it. Of course, Vegeta. And Vegeta's all butthurt how, you know, Goku's a Super Saiyan and he's not, so... blah, blah, blah this, blah, blah, blah that. No one gives a shit, Vegeta. He punches once. And you're now playing? No, I'm not. I think Vegeta just like reverse psychology'd his fucking like inner power and shit. Now, here's something I hate. And Boost Fury, Gohan. In the very beginning of the game, you get Super Saiyan. Here, you don't. You actually have to play for a bit in order. But let me go ahead and explain the mechanics for Super Saiyan. Like, all your characters after this, like, Vegeta instantly starts off with his second special move, which is... oh, let me demonstrate for you. Bam. Does a shit ton of damage. But he can't charge it up for that long, for a whole lot while. So let's go ahead and let Super Saiyan, see the little arrow? Like, right, that little yellow arrow next to our, on our hub bar. That indicates when you can go Super Saiyan. And Super Saiyan uses up your green bar. So it's best not to use Kai attacks or energy blast when you're in this form. Basically, you go faster and you do like a third or more damage. Oh, and to exit out of Super Saiyan, you can press B again. When you have the Z symbol up there. And we're actually going to do something that I said that's something I kind of put off earlier. Or talking to the scientists. Basically, this starts up the whole Namekian side quest. Now that Vegeta landed on Earth, we're not gonna worry about that now. We're gonna fight Krillin, Yamcha, and Tien. Which this doesn't make any sense. How you can fight them here, yet they're like, this is gonna be like. Oh crap, I forgot to get Vegeta's charge move. Damn man, he's kicking my ass. Go super, go super, go super. Damn man, I almost got my ass kicked right there. Okay, now I'm gonna cut right here and do something off screen. Okay, we're back, and I went off screen and went ahead and got some full health back. I didn't want to use my Sensu Beam, so I went ahead and went to one of the side areas and you know, just broke rocks, so I got full health. Now we go up against Krillin, which is surprisingly stronger than Yamcha. You wouldn't think that, but Yamcha is a failure and everything. I went ahead and got Vegeta's charge move. Ooh, almost lost that one right there. We got another capsule, which is always nice. Now, like I said, since I took a lot of damage, I'm going to hang cut right here and get full health again. Oh boy, I had to go through a lot of stuff to get back here, because I died on a random enemy, because I had little to no health left. Okay. And I died. I'll cut to when I finally beat what the fuck? on, bitch. You want to be cheap like that? I'm going to be cheap, too. You little asshole. What? I'm taking everything the cheap way. I don't give a fuck anymore. Just do this. Just spam this. That's all you gotta do. Fuck being fair and square. Being fair is for squares. Man, this guy didn't have 2,000 health. Or if I didn't die in 4 fucking hits, and I'm not wasting my Senzu being on a fucking optional battle. You can do this in the real game. It's not like I'm exploiting anything. And now I don't give a fuck about being fair and square. If I find a checkpoint, I'm going to use it. Though I will admit, this isn't really entertaining. Let's speed it up. Vegeta would probably be all like, I don't want to fight weaklings like you. Okay, before this part's over with, I want to show you something. It has to do with the charge attack. Go Super Saiyan, then charge your attack. But keep holding down A until you lose all your... What the fuck? Did he fix the glitch or something? It's supposed to be like a glitch where, it would still be shining. Like, how you're flashing right there. It would be like you're still flashing. Okay, well, the next part we'll fight some androids, and we, you know, this part we got Vegeta. We got Super Saiyan for the first time, and like I said, we're gonna fight some androids. See you Monday.